Jazz, it is the best American story.
Welcome to KC Jazz Soundtracks 1. Today's program is the first of four dedicated to movie music, instrumental jazz used in films. We begin with a Mancini tune going out to my womancinis about a certain oddly colored large cat.
We'll be right back.
Jerry Mulligan and Chet Baker with their walk-in shoes from the motion picture I Want to Live. I want to play a couple of songs used in the soundtrack for Good Night and Good Luck, starting with Django Reinhardt's version of a tune that's driving me crazy, man.
David Fathead Newman doing one for my baby and one more for the road.
KC Jazz. I'm Kev Carr on the Old School Radio Network.
We're playing movie music on today's show. Here's Dave Brubeck with a little Stardust. Ellington with a couple of offerings from 1959's Anatomy of a Murder, considered by many to be one of the best jazz movie soundtracks. From Duke playing Dixieland to the Dukes of Dixieland, Wolverine Blues is a song used by everyone from Woody Allen to Beavis and Butthead. We'll be right back.
Support for the Old School Radio Show comes from alumni of WRCR Radio.
Thank you.
Stan Getz and Bill Evans with the Carpetbaggers theme. Before that, it had to be you, Artie Shaw. And I mean that from the bottom of the big beating one. We're showcasing movie music on today's program. Here are a couple from Robert Altman's crime film, Kansas City.
Thank you.
Yeah, that really is KC Jazz. I'm Kev Carr on the Old School Radio Network.
Thank you.
Kansas City band played some Blues in the Dark, Froggy Bottom before that, finishing up our time together with two different versions of a 100-year-old tune used in many films, After You've Gone, from 8 Men Out, The Aviator, All That Jazz. Sadie McKee, Mr. Saturday Night, That Awkward Moment, The Newton Boys, The Singing Detective, Larger Than Life, Smaller Than Death. Thank you. James P. Johnson, preceded by Roy Eldridge. Tune in next time for more movie music on KC Jazz, Soundtracks 2. Thanks for listening. We'll close the way we began with more Mancini, this one used in the Thomas Crown Affair, like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning on an ever-spinning reel. Wait, that guy wasn't in the Thomas Crown Affair, I'm sure of it.